In Osama City, you're watching One TV News Channel. One TV News Channel. Serving you with information, news, sports, and public affairs. One TV News Channel. One TV News Channel. Serving you with love. Ang telebisyon pangmasa. One TV News Channel. One TV News Channel. One TV special, 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 special report, special report.
Secretary Federal.
Honorable Neri.
Present.
Honorable Quinty Cipres. Honorable Lim. Honorable Ko. Honorable Romero Risikan. Honorable Suiso.
Present.
Honorable Bation. Honorable Salvador. Honorable Lau, Honorable Sakin Jr., Honorable Waminal Jr., Honorable Tapayan, there are 12 members present, including the Honorable Chairman of the Committee of the Whole.
Having 12 members present, the Chair declares a quorum. Once again, good afternoon. This Committee of the Whole is now called for the following agenda. One is the request of the Municipal Trial Courts and Cities Branch 2, MTCC of Osamis City, through Mr. Jonas Pangilinan, to the Sangguniang Pamungsod to the City, to adopt a resolution in order to effect the rate of execution of judgment of the Appointed Court of Civilities Number MTCC as to adhere paragraph Section 2 of the City Ordinance of 1240-22. And the second item is the issuance of land title of timberland in alienable land in coastal barangays in this city to it San Antonio, Katadman, Carmen Annex, and Malaubang. Again, good afternoon. May I request Honorable a majority floor leader for the proceedings of our hearing for today.
Yes, Honorable Chair, thank you. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everybody. Before we proceed, I would like to request our secretary to acknowledge our visitors or guests for this afternoon's hearing on the channel.
May the secretary acknowledge our visitors for today's committee hearing.
Yes, Honorable Chair, this afternoon we have the presence of the following visitors. We have Mr. Reyes Fernandez from Penro, Mr. Dennis E. Huap from Sindro, Osami City, Mr. Harold Sevilla, Mrs. Edin Kambangay, from the Department of Natural Resources. Likewise, Honorable Chair, we have the presence of the following barangay officials from Barangay Katadman. We have Barangay Kagawad Edwin Amba, Barangay Kagawad Leonida Irug-Irug, Barangay Kagawad Arturo Maghinay. We have also the presence of Jonas Pangilinan, Siri, Municipal Trial Court of Cities. Barangay Kagawad Sabino Espantilan, Katadman Manabay. Barangay Kagawad Bugas of Barangay Katadman Manabay. Mr. Remihildo Kabaag, Maria Linda Junior, Mrs. Gliceria Diosola, Mrs. Ima Cabajo, Mr. Michael Makadada, Makakanda, Mr. Arnold Lumongo Maria, Joseph Tabotabo, Cyrus Basmayor, Sarona Santos, Jocelyn Macalla, Estrella Abukay from San Antonio, Eva Salomon, Barangay Cagawa, San Antonio. Nolan Labadisos, Barangay Cagawa, San Antonio. Marley Caballero, Barangay Cagawa, San Antonio. Rodel Tamigil, Punong Barangay, Barangay San Barangay Cagawa. Rodel Tamigil, Punong Barangay, San Antonio. Erlito, Apatan, Punong Barangay, Katadman, Manabay. Mikaela Aguliras, Barangay Sekretary, Katadman, Manabay. Mr. Hirunggay, from Katadman, Manabay. Rosami Carion. Mrs. Gloria Lomo, Mrs. Mila Tinamisan, Daniel Polis Kagawan, Bin Mrs. Amelita Mano, Limsa Puentes, Juanita Candia, Warlito Puentes, Alilor Aranilia from the Department of Environment and Natural Resources, Pili Cabuco, Samuel Cristuta, Clinton Sevilla, Barangay Cagawa, San Antonio, Gisanil Tamparo from the City Welfare Development Office, Marina Kailan, Barangay Secretary, Carmen Anix, Claire Candungo, Barangay Treasurer, Carmen Anix, Otelo Silva, Kagawad, Barangay Carmen Anix, Alex Pacana, Kagawad, Barangay Carmen Anix, Michael K. Filipino, Barangay Kagawad, Edison J. Filipino, Iski Chairman, and Mr. And likewise, Madam Chair, we acknowledge the presence of our Chief Legal Officer, Attorney Buen Cassandra Libertario.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. Honorable Chair, as introduction, as mentioned by the Honorable Chair, this administrative hearing is specifically triggered by the letter of the Sheriff of Municipal Tayo Pagnay Cities, Branch 2, requesting the Edge of Sanis to have an approval of the activity of the court to execute the judgment of the civil case number 2138 before the MCC Branch 2 soliciting and the Sheriff wanted to comply with the ordinance number 1242-2022 requiring national government agencies to first seek prior consultation and approval of the NGO before conducting any activity or projects or programs under the agency concern. So, incidentally and significantly also, there arises an issue which also imbued with public interest, which needs decision because this is a social public involved, because certain residents of Barangay San Antonio will be evicted as a result of the judicial judgment by the court. We, of course, understand that the sheriff as a duty, in accordance with his function and job as a sheriff, to execute a judgment. But we have also the collaborating duty and mandate, according to the law, that we have to investigate in accordance with our ordinance 1240-2022 to determine the exigency of the project, because it's mandated by law, Local Government Code Section 2, which requires prior consideration to the NGO before any entity will conduct this activity. And I am particularly concerned also the provision of teaching the children of the local government court, which is final presentations required, no project or program shall be implemented by the government authorities unless the conditions mentioned in Section 2, Section 2. And this is complied with, and final approval of the Civilian Reserve is obtained. Provided this is the concern of the Civilian, provided the occupants in areas where such projects are to be implemented shall not be evicted unless appropriate action, appropriate relocation sites have been provided in accordance with the provisions of the Constitution. So, mo ni provision na nagmantara ka mo, nga may physical, kailangan may eviction nga may tawag. Certain owners o property sa barangay sa Antonio will be required to vacate in accordance with the shield report. MCC, the final na executory. So, this involves the public interest because there are allegations by the residents of Bayan San Antonio that the land which is occupied, obviously will be evicted, is timberland. That's an allegation, a serious allegation. And we know for a fact, as a lawyer, I am a lawyer for more than 25 years, I know that timberland cannot be subject to title, give to the man. Timberland is beyond the commerce of man. Gani, na ay mga provisions of law na akong gihangi ato si Klare na iyang research. Doon ay mga properties ang dinigil ba rito, direct to the plan. Number one, property of public dominion. Number two, public dominion, kanyang mga parks, mga kasuks parks, na posibleng mga parks, direct to the plan. Okay, gobyerno ang tagiha. Forest lands. Saan ka ba na timber lands? Dahil na ako eh. Watersheds. Mangrove swamps. Masih kami mangrove swamps ada lagi tuan. Mineral lands, national parks, and military or naval institutions. So, it worries us because there is allegation nga ang ilang po yung timberland kung nasa tuan. Of course, we do not object to the court decision. Kaya pahitan na. Ang among concern nga, nga nung natutuluhan, na di rin man pwede kutinoon ang allegation na Timberland. So, we receive also a document from the DNR na as early as April 16, 2021, doon order of investigation kanayukta sa Bangay San Antonio. Doon na petition na ang moyuta allegation na was anomalously titled and registered to Pascual Mayor. Na doon ay order of investigation na pagkaimoon ang DNR bahin sa alis nga fake o gilingal title. And thereafter, an investigation report shall be submitted within this from termination of the investigation. We inquired from DNR kung ano ba investigation. And until now, we were informed na wala yung MCG na kahimbo sa DNR, pari sa region. So, we need to know, anong wala yung MCG siyon? E kung naapa, pasi na may pabot ay panahon ha. And may tabo ang Castellani. So, please invite the public attention of the General. Not only that, we are preparing the ordinance in accordance with ordinance 1248 has been built into, but also we are trying to inquire why there is an allegation, a very serious allegation, that Timberland and Samis were titled sa San Antonio. Yeah, we also received complaints, written complaints from Barangay Tamang Nabay. Also, I did choose na nai yutak, Timberland sa na natin tuluhan. Nasamot sa Amerika kita mga Nabay. Ang wino pa pa kanapoy similar situation sa Barangay Blaubang o sa Barangay Kananix. That's why we invited also the public pisa sa Barangay Blaubang ang Kananix. Kaya ay mga Timberland na napita o na election na natin tuluhan po. So, this phenomenon is recurring and will involve public interest. Okay? Kung isasar sa Samis at Timberland, kita doon, mapitan ang Edios Samis. Muna, we have to investigate this once for all, not only to comply with the letter of the Senate, but also to know the deeper reasons why these properties, which are alleged to be Timberlands or properties public domain, which beyond the commercial man, not titled man, in violation of the civil law and the law on titles and deeds. So, Honorable Sir, we will try to be very objective in this mission as fast as possible. I know my colleagues are veterans in investigation, but na ka naman pagpisigal na ang mga kaya kita na objective based ang pagpisigal. Walang overpower. We want to know the truth para we'll be able to come up with appropriate decision na maka-assess sa pagsulbat sa problema nining atong subject matter. So, to begin with, Honorable Chair, we'll first request the Senate who is the source of all this activity now to give a statement nga no unsa yung trabaho, nga no pangsyon niya, nga no iyang secret adjustment sa court. Okay, the Senate should not be blamed, okay, yan trabaho na yun. Ngayon, secret adjustment, that is his job. But in performing his job, it's required by law to consult the NGO. Pinaka-renansa. Ang approval of the NGO. Ang City Council ma-approve sa iyan. Request. Muna ka nag-hearing time. Isin talaga, nai-light issue na sino support. No? At kung itakot na nga hearing, kung nanapoy ito ka parang naman na, ay loba ko the next. So, and also we request the rules to be submitted to allow the city to speak for us.
Okay, thank you, Honorable Majority Floor Leader, for your manifestation. At this point in time, I would like to acknowledge the presence.
Siri.
Of the Siri, okay.
Good afternoon, Your Honor. Good afternoon, Honorable Councilors of the City. Your Honor, I am Jonas Pangilinan, Sheriff of MDCC Branch 1, but because of the untimely death of the Sheriff of Branch 2, I am the designated Sheriff of MPCC Branch 2 as well, and Branch 3. Your Honor, last March, then by the end of March this year, Your Honor, I received a copy of the writ of execution coming from MPCC Branch 2, ordering the this representation to execute the order that was given by, was signed by the former judge, Rio Concepcion Atchas, Your Honor. And I was ordered by the Honorable Judge of NPCC Branch 2, the acting presiding judge, Arnel Rimpilio, to act on the matter as the order was given last 2020. But due to the pandemic, the former sheriff postponed the execution for humanitarian reasons that we have received a memorandum coming from the Supreme Court to delay the execution on matters pertaining to eviction and demolition cases. Your Honor, going back, I received the order and I was ordered to act on the matter. I then served the writ of execution to the defendants mentioned under the mentioned on civil case number 2138 on San Antonio Uzami City. After I have served the writ of execution, Your Honor, I then served to them the notice to vacate as part of the procedure last April 1. After this, Your Honor, as part of the procedure, I have made several attempts to make the defendants understand about the nature of the execution, Your Honor, and due to some threats that was that the sheriff encountered during the service of notice to vacate, Your Honor, and during the relocation survey, because we conducted relocation survey, Your Honor, so that we will not wrongly serve notices to those who are not included in the decision. So because of the threat, Your Honor, and the emotions involved in the pertaining to the defendants, Your Honor, I seek the assistance of the PNP for the security and the smooth implementation of the order. I then, as per the protocol from the, as advised by the city police, Your Honor, the request should be addressed to the regional office, and that's what I did. I submitted a letter request from the to the region, and then received a reply, Your Honor, from the PNP regional office informing me about the approval of the request. But Your Honor, the city police reminded me of the existing ordinance, Your Honor, that any activity, programs, or projects should be approved by the local government of Uzami City. So I then submitted a letter to the mayor's office, Your Honor, seeking and informing about the writ of execution that I am about to implement. And as of the moment, Your Honor, the city police also informed, Your Honor, that only then we can proceed with the execution together with the assistance that they are going to provide if the approval will be given. So as of the moment, Your Honor, there are no defendants or residents that I have evicted physically yet with respect to the ordinance of our City of Uzami, Your Honor. That will be all, Your Honor. Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Pangilinan.
Honorable Sir, of course, you have to have also the other stakeholders, meaning the owner of title land, no? And also the occupants, my bank. At ako po na, from APSA, ito ako po siya, ala sa muna akong siya, siya rin, o karipay, ulang mo siya, Honorable Asir, di ba na ay lumaan ng Supreme Court na kung na ay kung wala impossible letters decided will first consult the CCBB of the NGO. Laban ang ayaw-awil ng Honorable Supreme Court.
Yes, yes, Your Honor. In fact, Your Honor, the Office of the Court Administrator Circular Number 328-2022 mandated the executing sheriffs to provided the circular provided the procedural guidelines in cases of demolition and eviction. Included in this circular and procedure, Your Honor, procedural guidelines is that the sheriff must coordinate with the concerned local government unit, including the Philippine Commission for Urban Poor, the DILG, Human Rights, and other agencies that would be an aid for the persons that will be displaced. But Your Honor, this circular number 328-2022 was set aside when the circular number 75-2024 came out last March 14, 2024. So, the procedural guidelines in cases of demolition and eviction was set aside by the OCA circular number 75-2024. But despite, Your Honor, the issuance of the circular, Your Honor, the sheriff still submits to the ordinance of the city, Your Honor, that I have to inform and ask and seek for the approval of the city before conducting the activity, Your Honor.
So, in the commission, imo na nagsulta ang atong si Sir Luis, imo nga rin kami nyo, bahay na rin nga ito. Imo na nga isita, nagsulta si imo nga rin kami nyo sa si Sir Luis.
No, Your Honor, because not yet, Your Honor.
Oh, okay, Mr. Mayor is asking me kung dito na makasasimple. So I'm asking you now.
Yes, Your Honor, I would like to inform the Honorable Counsel, Your Honor, that on my previous executions, Your Honor, prior to this case, I have made coordination with the concerned agencies, Your Honor, but because last March, Your Honor, the circular 75-2024 coming from the Office of the Court Administrator came out, that prompted the sheriff to proceed without informing the agencies, because the procedural guidelines was set aside as of March 14, 2024, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you. So, ato ang pumilang karon ang pentip. Of course, we do not blame here because what does it say? Don't you think balik?
Yes, Your Honor. The order was dictated 2020, Your Honor, October 2020.
Nandiyan na tayo, it was COVID. Una, we cannot blame us for it, diba? Gusto na i-mention ang decision. Kaya na mention as early as 2020. So, we'll have to hear now the Pat Mayor Pangani, presented by Elizabeth Mayor. Sana ba? Ma'am, we'll hear you, ma'am.
By Saloma Santos, Your Honor, is one of the years. Saloma Santos.
Wala si Elizabeth
Mayor. Saloma
Santos.
Ma'am, Sir Santos.
Ma'am, Saloma Santos, ma'am, sir, for help to speak to us regarding their special and very settlement.
Welcome guys, Ma'am Saloma Santos.
Welcome everyone. I am Saloma Santos, a teacher from Laguna National High School, and I am presently living in San Antonio. Actually, as one of the year of Pascual was mayor, I am only one who is here now for representing the one, because my father and my mother is already dead years ago. So So far, as I remember, that case is already filed and filed in court for already 21 years last August 2020 when we get the decision. But sad to say, it was because of the COVID, it was not able to implement. That's why the court or our counsel filed motion for execution of the writ of filed motion to execute the writ of execution in the court. So we are scheduled to have the hearing on May 6, 2024, and it was said by the judge that the judgment or decision is already final and executory, and it was pronounced really by the judges really many times or three times. It was discussed or told at the court that it is already final and executory, and now we are waiting for the approval of the LGU to assist us at the police, for we want to have a peaceful vacate of the defendants. That's all. Thank you.
In Osama City, you're watching One TV News Channel. One TV News Channel. Serving you with information, news, sports, and public affairs. One TV News Channel. One TV News Channel. Serving you with love. Ang telebisyon pangmasa. One TV News Channel. One TV News Channel. One TV special report.